What's the biggest thing people get wrong about One Nation voters?
They probably think that One Nation voters are crazy because they vote for Pauline.
There's plenty of people who don't want to say anything because they're scared of the repercussions. They're scared of walking down the street and going, oh, there's that redneck bloody Muslim hater. Or, you know, there's that bloody bogan. What's a bogan? I don't wear a flannelette shirt. I can't grow a mullet. Mm. I don't smoke Winnies. So I can't be a bogan.
Right.
Get to know me before you judge me.
Do you think you should get to know Muslims before you judge them?
They just walk past you like a vapor.
It's possible they're afraid of you.
Why would they be afraid of me?
So when people talk about One Nation, you almost only ever hear about one person, Pauline Hanson. But what about the people that support her? We're here in Mackay. It is sugarcane country. It's also one of the parts of Australia that's seen a huge rise in support for One Nation. And we're here to find out why. What is it that matters to people here? What are they afraid of? What are they angry about? And why is it that they are leaving major parties like the LNP and Labor, for that matter, in droves?
Nathan is a father of five. He's a qualified mechanic, currently out of work, but he's keeping busy in the most Australian way possible, by fixing up a Tirana.
Nathan.
How are you, champion?
Nice to meet you. Why is it important to have the Australian flag here? What does that mean to you?
Well, it means a hell of a lot to me. That was my grandfather's.
Yep.
And he was in the army. Mm. And that was what was draped over his coffin.
And the baseball bat?
It's my alarm.
Your alarm?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
So I come out going, woo, 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 woo.
So we're going around talking to people about why Pauline Hanson is so popular. What's your take? Why is she so popular?
She pretty much stands for what most of us want, which is back to Australian values.
So when you say Australian values, what are we talking about? What's missing?
Our culture's been taken away from us in the way of, you know, the influx of refugees. I'm probably going to be called a redneck or a bigot or Islamophobe for saying the amount of Muslims we're taking in.
But I look around and there's not that many Muslim people in Mackay.
There's not a huge minority of Muslims in Mackay, but there is a small minority.
In what way are they changing your way of life?
Well, they're not personally changing my way of life. They're changing the Australian culture, okay. Australian way of life.
It's interesting you say that, right? Because I was in year six when Pauline Hanson first came to power back in the 90s.
And yep.
Her big argument then was that Australia was going to be overrun
Chinese.
By... well, yeah, Asians. And so my mum's from Singapore.
Yep.
And I remember watching that and going, oh, she's talking about my mum. But you fast forward a generation and I'm here. We can have
yep.
a perfectly good
exactly
conversation.
Exactly right, mate.
But who's to say that that's not going to happen with the next generation of immigrants from Muslim countries?
Well, that could be so. But from what we've seen right now, have they tried?
Okay. Before you voted One Nation, you would have voted LNP?
No, I bloody had to, but anyway.
Turnbull, thoughts?
Oh, yeah, all right. Next question. When was the last politician that can actually honestly say he's lived like an Australian? Going out and actually working for a bloody living.
Yeah.
Knowing how hard it is to actually put food on the table, pay your bills. Mm. And it is, at the moment, hard to find a job.
In this area?
In this area, yeah.
Nathan is part of a shift that's making the major parties nervous. Here in Mackay, we're in George Christensen's electorate, where a poll earlier this year put support for One Nation neck and neck with support for the Liberal National Party.
I know for a fact that some of the LNP members, they won't be voting LNP.
Actual members of the party?
Yes. I shouldn't be saying that.
Terry and James were members of the LNP for almost three decades. They've now torn up their membership. The breaking point for them was the construction of a highway on their doorstep, a project of both the state and federal governments.
As a family, we are giving up a house that was built in 1936 that belonged to our daughter and her husband and her two children. That's been taken away. See where all the trees are?
Oh, right.
That's where her house was there. We are giving up our lifestyle because we've got a road that will be 45 metres from our front boundary. The government doesn't care about us.
Would you ever vote LNP again?
No.
So who are you going to vote for next?
I don't know. I'm still making my decisions about that.
Why does One Nation appeal? What is it that she and they are saying that matters to people in this area?
People are disillusioned and feel like they are not getting effective representation, and the protest vote would be significant. I think Pauline Hanson is a strong lady and she's not afraid to speak.
Now, whether or not Hanson would even speak up for James and Terry about their road is an unknown. But like a lot of people in Mackay, they're simply looking for an alternative.
How many of your friends do you reckon voted One Nation in the last election?
Probably about a third of them.
And they would have all been LNP voters beforehand?
Very likely.
Yeah, right.
Yes.
It's not just the LNP losing votes to One Nation. When Pauline Hanson first won federal office back in 1998, most of her support came from coalition defectors. Jump forward to last year's federal election and One Nation were picking up equal numbers of disgruntled Labor voters. Last time around, it was mostly men voting for One Nation. More recently, women have turned to Pauline in increasing numbers. And it's not just James and Terry's friends voting for One Nation. In the Mackay area, recent polling shows that a big chunk of One Nation support is coming from young people.
So what do you guys think of Pauline Hanson?
She's at red.
She's just like keeping Australia Australia. Instead of like letting other laws come in and that. But yeah, I reckon she's good. Like she should be Prime Minister.
She's probably the Donald Trump of Australia. Yeah, I don't think she does much good for Australia.
I think she's honest, and I think it's a good thing. We need honest people, especially in our politicians.
Yeah, I think Pauline Hanson's a true Aussie who is not afraid to speak for the Aussie people.
We know you get jobs because overseas people get jobs.
Well, you got a job, bud.
No, I do.
Yeah, so why are you complaining?
I don't.
Yes, you do.
I'm Damien Aegis, I'm 22 years old. I'm a fourth generation cane farmer. And I'm also a country music singer. Wouldn't guess it, but I am. Let the politicians and the bankers in the city look up and wonder if they glow
in the sky. Let the king be burn. Cheers. So what is it about One Nation that speaks to people in this area?
So everyone's pissed at LNP, and everyone in this area hates Labor.
All right, so let's go through what are the problems you'd like solved. What are the things you want fixed?
My great-grandfather fought in World War II to keep foreign countries taking over our country.
Yeah.
They don't have to go to war anymore, they just got to buy it. The sugar industry is slowly getting sold off, the ports are getting sold, everything's getting sold to foreigners. Like, what does Australia own anymore? Mackay Sugar is the only Australian-owned sugar mill in Australia left. And they're $215 million in debt. And there's a big, massive thing, like, they're saying, oh, we should sell up. No one wants to sell because they don't want to get sold to a foreign investor, so.
Is Pauline going to fix that, though?
I don't know. She reckons that she's for the farmer.
People from the southern states, so I'm from Sydney, try not to hold it against me. When people hear of a One Nation voter, they instantly assume that that person is a racist redneck. Is that a fair impression of somebody considering voting One Nation?
No, I'm a redneck. I'm not racist at all.
But would voting One Nation make you a racist redneck?
No. It's my opinion. I'm not racist, but if I seen someone in a full, whatever, burqa,
yeah,
walking towards me, I'd walk on the other side of the street.
Why?
Of course I'm going to like, what the hell, is she could have something under there, I wouldn't know. Boom, boom, Allah Akbar. No, run the other way.
Have you ever seen anybody in the full niqab in Mackay?
Not really. I think once.
Right.
A few years ago.
Okay. Do you think part of the appeal, perhaps, of Pauline Hanson is that she voices things that people think but feel uncomfortable saying out loud?
Yeah. Well, there is no freedom of speech anymore. Everyone gets so offended over everything now. And Pauline is trying to make it so that you can't have your freedom of speech again. If you see it best, when you say nothing at all,
Despite the glowing sunrises in One Nation's heartland, Hanson supporters are decidedly gloomy about Australia's prospects. 73% thought that the national economy was a little or a lot worse than it was a year ago. And more than 80% of One Nation voters feel that immigration is extremely important when deciding which way to vote.
I think it's the uncertainty. You don't know whether the next one's got that bomb in their pocket.
But immigration policy isn't the only reason people vote for Pauline Hanson.
She is useful. She is very useful.
Steve works at the meatworks here in Mackay, and so he wasn't thrilled when the federal government announced a plan to turn prime cattle grazing land into a military training ground. You know who else wasn't thrilled?
You know, do the job you're supposed to be doing, all right? And leave me alone for a change. I'm sick and tired of it.
Suddenly she turns up in the spit scene and mountains were moved and miracles were made and suddenly the army don't need all that land so the cattle farmers can keep on doing what they're doing. As I said, they're useful, but whether I'd vote for them, I honestly don't know. I don't think it would, but then we don't know what surprises the other two parties are going to come up with either.
So why wouldn't you vote for her then? What is it that stops you?
It's sort of the whole One Nation package. Anybody can make a mag of themselves being racist, and she's pretty good at it actually.
But does voting for One Nation instantly make a person racist?
Well, I honestly don't know. Like, is the Labor Party just the unions, or is the Liberal Party just the big banks? Mm. You know, too simple, far too simple an answer.
One of the big issues that's come up with, as we talk to people, is their concern about Muslim immigration, that we're going to let in terrorists. Is that a big issue around here? Does that affect people in Mackay?
I had a workmate at work on the same shift. He was a Muslim sparky, electrician. And you couldn't have met a nicer bloke and a better sparky, you know? And the thing is, when I go to work, I pass a local mosque.
And if he went into that mosque, he'd meet this guy. This is Mohib. He's 25, he was raised in Wyong, and he is the imam of Mackay's one and only mosque, which around 50 local families attend.
Because the mosque is on the highway, yeah. So we get people that are hurling insults. All we do is just wave to them, wave and smile. That's what I learned from my father, right, after everyone started calling him Osama bin Laden because of his beard.
So your wife wears the full niqab. Does that separate her from the rest of Mackay? Do you think that's actually aiding that separation?
I don't believe it is, actually. Once I was in Coles with my wife, and she was wearing the face view, the niqab, and a girl, she asked her parents that, why is she wearing this? And I heard the answer of the father, and I really liked it. I wanted to shake his hand afterwards. He said that, does anyone ask you why you're wearing your clothes? What does it matter what she's wearing?
What would you say to somebody that says, Muslims, people like you, don't represent Australian values?
No, I feel that we do represent Australian values. The fact that we're allowed to practice our religion without fear of prosecution and without fear of harassment, I think that's one of the biggest values of Australia. I've been in cricket clubs, I go to the golf club here. I've never felt alienated in Australia because this is my home. I've grown up here. Anyone tells me to go back home, I go back to my house, and that's it. I mean, we get heaps so much help from the neighbours that we have at the mosque as well. Chris and Doug, shout out.
So if you could say anything to a One Nation supporter, the sort of person that wants to put a blanket ban on all Muslim immigration, what would you say?
I'd invite them to meet more Muslims to get an understanding of that, how we've been living in this country since the 1800s.
Have you met anybody in Mackay who is Muslim, out of curiosity?
Have I gone up personally, shook their hand, going, hey, g'day mate, how you going?
Yeah.
Nah.
Okay. Would you?
No.
Not even if like it results in a conversation like this where you get to understand them, they get to understand you, they get to understand your concerns?
Possibly, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to knock a bloke back and say, oh, I'm not going to talk to you.
I'm not 100% on the no Muslim immigration. Like, yes, there is the extremists out there, but they're just some genuine people. I went to school with kids that they went to the Islamic Center every weekend to pray for whatever they do. Like, we can't ban a religion. It's just, You cannot do it.
Would that stop you from voting One Nation?
Not really. I really like what she's doing, to be honest. She wouldn't have to do much more. Just, she needs to not do what I do and contradict herself.
She's done plenty of that.
Yeah, she does plenty of that, and I do too.
Speaking to One Nation supporters here in Mackay, you're faced with 1,000 contradictions. But there's some things that we know for sure.
People here, they are angry, they are afraid, but they're also intensely proud of being Australian. Whether or not Pauline and One Nation can solve their problems, no one here actually knows.
The question is, this groundswell of support, is it the peak for One Nation? Or is it just the beginning?